Hello students. So in the last class we have discussed some basics laws of network theory. So today we are going to start with the numericals involved in Ohm's law, KCL, KVL, current divider rule, voltage divider rule, etc. Okay, it's lecture number 5. It's a Prashant Hansi. So we'll start with the numerical based on KVL. Okay. Okay, consider the circuit. It is having 2 kilo ohm resistor. The supplied voltage, say 100 volts. One more resistor in series, that is 8 kilo ohm. Question is that find the loop current or current flowing through the circuit. Current flowing through the circuit is what? We need to find the current flowing through the circuit. For this kind of numericals, we need to denote or assume any loop current, say by showing the direction like this. So this is the loop current. We'll assume that current is flowing in this way. I'll denote with the notation say I. So as I explained in the KVL concept, so current entering the resistor is taken as positive sign, exit sign as what? Negative sign. See, coming to this point here, this resistor, 8K resistor, entry will be what? Plus sign. Again, exit will be what? Minus sign. This is how we need to denote. Now by using KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage law, we need to write the equation for this, right? So now look into one by one. I'll assume that here these nodes are A, B, C, D. Since it is a first numerical, I'll explain in detail. Okay, so you start applying the KVL equation from point A to B. See, current flowing through this branch is what? I. So what is the drop across this 2K resistor? We know that from Ohm's law, V is equal to I into R, right? So R is how much here? 2K. What is I here? We have assumed that I is what? Capital I, that we need to find out now. Okay. So therefore, so I can write here 2K into I, right? So because entry sign will be plus, this sign should be considered. Similarly, that same current is entering at 8k ohm. So here also I should write 8k I. Then coming to this path here, no resistor, no drops. Here we have the voltage source. See, this in this side sign will be what? Minus. Should write minus. What is the value of voltage source? 100, which is must be equal to 0. So you can rewrite this one as 2k plus 8k common. So this will be I, which is equal to 100. If I take that minus 100 this side, this will become what? Plus 100. So this is what? These are the voltage drops. This is the source. From the KVL, we know that in any closed electrical circuit path, voltage source value must be equal to voltage drops. So this will become what? 10k I, 10 kilo ohm to I, which is equal to 100. We need to find I value here. So that is I equal to 100 divided by 10k. If I simplify this one, be 1 p 10. So this kilo, if it will come in numerical numerator, so this I will become what? 10 milliampere, or 10 milliamps. This is the answer. Okay, so this I value, what we have assumed is what? 10 milliamperes. The same question they may ask, like what is the voltage drop across 2 kilo ohm? For this, I into R. What is I value here? 10 milliamperes, right? What is R value here? 2K, right? So this will become how much? This milli and kilo will get cancelled. This will become what? 20 volts. Similarly, voltage across 8K will be what? I into R again. I will be what? 10 milliampere. Right. Into what? 8K. Right. This milli and this kilo will get cancelled. So we'll get what? 80 volts. We can assume here, see, the applied voltage is what? 100 volts. The voltage drop across this 2K will be how much? 20 volts. Then voltage drop across 8K will be how much? 80 volts. Therefore, in any closed electrical circuit, voltage source is of 100 volts, which is must be equal to drop in the voltage drops in the circuit. Here 20 volt drop, here 80 volts drop, therefore 100 volts, right? So voltage source is equal to sum of the voltage drops. This is the basic numerical of KVL. Okay, move on to the next numerical. So we'll consider a circuit, basic circuit again. Find the loop currents for the given electrical circuits. Now we'll see the circuit how it will be. So it is given with the resistors then with the two voltage source in this way. Here also one more voltage source. Give the value later. Okay. So this is the 15 ohm. This is 30 ohm. This is 20 ohm. This is 100 volts. This is 50 volts. Right. So need to find the loop currents. Here how many loops we have? See, there are two closed circuit path, means we have two loops here, right? So we know that this end is minus, this is plus, this is minus, this is plus. Now we'll see how exactly we need to find the loop currents. See, I'll assume the loop current in this way, the first loop, say as I1. So in this loop I'll take in this fashion, say I'll take this one as say I2. So we know that sign convention, when current entering into a particular resistor, so we'll take it as positive end, this one as negative. Here the same I1 is entering here at 20 ohm with a plus sign and exit with a minus sign. No further resistors, leave this one. So consider here, at this resistor we have 30 ohm entering point. At this point, this is plus, this is minus. Again here this is plus, this is minus. Now we need to apply a KVL for this and to get the equation, right? So I'll explain. We start from this point. So what is the sign appearing here? Here it is, so right here it is a minus 50. Then that I1 is appearing here, so this is plus, plus, 15 I1 plus, next this is very important, 20 ohm resistor is there. This is not only related to I1 loop current, it is also related with the I2. But what is the I2 direction here? The same as what? I1. Both currents are coming the same way. So therefore 20 in bracket I1 plus I2. No further terms are there. So this will be what? 0 equals to 0. You simplify this one. This is I1. Okay. Simplify this one. What will get? This is minus 50 plus 50 I1 plus 20 I1 plus 20 I2, which is equal to 0. So see, here we have the two I1 terms. Adding these, so we'll get 35 I1 plus 20 I2, which is equal to 50. We'll call such equation number 1. Okay, this is applying what? KVL to first loop. Okay, so similarly apply KVL to second loop. So start from this point. See, minus 100 will appear first, minus 100. Next here plus 30 I2 plus 30 I2. Next here 20 is there, but it is common to I1 and I2. So therefore 20 I2 plus I1, which is must be equals to 0, right? So further, so need to simplify this one. Minus 100 plus 30 I2 plus 20 I2 plus 20 I1, which is equal to 0. So rearrange the terms. 20 I1 plus 50 I2, which is equal to what? 100. I will call some equation number. Okay, from the equation number 1 and 2, so you can get the values of I1 and I2 either by using Cramer's rule, that is matrix method, or using a simultaneous equation method, or using directly a calculator method. Okay, so we'll discuss these two methods in later classes. So in a calculator we have two variables and two equations method. We have directly, if you enter the values, these values, matrix values, will get the values of those unknown variable directly. So by using that method, we need to express that in terms of matrix first. Coefficients of I1 and I2 in the first equation, we should write here 35 and 20. Okay, here coefficients of I1 and I2 are here 20 and 50. Here I1, here I2, the constant and right hand side are 50 and 100. By solving, so we will get I1 a value as, say, 0.3703 amperes, as well as I2 value as, say, 1.518 amperes. This is all about the what loop currents, say I1 loop current and I2 loop current. So in the same question, they may ask like, what is your voltage drop across 15 ohm? This can be calculated as current flowing through it and the corresponding resistor. Current flowing through that resistor will be what? Say I1. So this can be written as I1 into 15. What is the value of I1? 0.37. 0.37 into 15. So many volts, right? Similarly, they may ask like, what is the voltage drop across 30 ohm? So this will be, what is the current flowing through that 30 ohm? I2. So therefore, I2 into R. So that will be what? I2 value is what? 1.8518 into 30. So many volts. Similarly, they may ask like, what is the voltage drop across 20 ohm? So this will be, current here will be what? I1 plus I2. So into 20. So many volts. The same question. So they may ask in other ways also. So one more thing is that same numerical can be solved in many ways. So I'll consider the same circuit. Okay, I'll consider the same circuit. And again, I'll solve in another way. Okay, that will be discussed in the next video. Okay, thank you.